Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I am Vikram. In this class, we'll try to understand clocked SR latch or SR flip-flop. In our previous class, we have seen how SR latch will work. So, and how a bit of memory can be created by using the SR latch has been clearly explained in our previous video. If you haven't watched that video, please watch that video and come back here, because the understanding of SR latch is very much important for you to understand what is this, how a SR flip flop will work. Now coming to this class, we will try to, and every video in our channel is going to be a part of entire course or a playlist. Our suggestion is to follow the entire course so that you can have better understanding of the concepts. And the link for the playlist is provided in the description below. This is the circuit diagram for the SR flip-flop, and this part of the SR flip-flop has already been seen in our previous video. In our previous video, we have seen how to construct a SR flip-flop by using NAND gates. So to this SR flip-flop, using the SR latch using the NAND gates, we have added this part, and to this an extra input has been added, which is called as clock. So what is this clock? Why we need a clock in the flip-flop circuits? Why we need a clock in the flip-flop circuit is in order to produce a synchronous effect, which means, for example, if you try to give the inputs in a continuous way, to this circuit, so the things which are getting stored will get overwritten by the continuous stream of inputs. Before collecting the inputs by other circuit, before collecting the memory, the value that is stored in the circuit, so this value will get overwritten. So for example, if this memory, if you are trying to store one onto this circuit, so we have seen the different cases how to store one onto this circuit by using the S to 1. By setting the S to 1, we can store the value of 1 on this memory unit. And if you give the inputs continuously onto this circuit, what happens is these values will change frequently. Very fastly these values will change. And if these values are to be taken by another circuit, if another circuit is using this value, but if the inputs are given in a continuous way, the values will be overwritten and those values may not be taken by that circuit. So in order to have a synchronization, in order to have a system, in order to generate a system among the circuitry, what we are going to do is we are going to produce a signal called, we are going to give a signal called clock. So what this clock signal will be? So the clock signal is going to be a continuous flow of zeros and ones. So this is a clock signal, and this represents 0 and this represents 1. So whenever the clock is 1, whenever the input of clock is 1, then only this circuit will change, otherwise it will not change. So what is the logic behind that? So the logic behind that is, so it is based upon the truth table of the NAND gate. So what is the, so this is a clock, a continuous flow of zeros and ones. So whenever the value of 1 is produced at the clock, then only this circuit will work, and this entire space, when whenever this value is 0, then the circuit will remain same, which means it will not have any impact of the inputs. The impacts will not create any impact. So the inputs will not create any impact on this circuit. Okay. So when the clock is 0, why this circuit is not changing? Why this circuit is not changing is, if you take the truth table of NAND gate, it is A, B and function F. So this part, this is a NAND gate. So whenever any one of the input is 0, the value is going to be 1. So if the clock is 0, whenever one of the input is 0, so both these inputs are, one of the input is 0. So for this NAND gate, this input is 0, and this, for this NAND gate, this input is 0. So it is going to produce an output of 1. See here, if the inputs are having at least one 0, So it is going to produce an output of 1. See here, this is having 1 0. So it is going to, 2 zeros are there. If at least 1 0 is there, means then AND is going to produce an output of 1. So what happens here is we are going to produce an output of 1. So in our previous class, we have seen that. So for this NAND SR latch, so the 1-1 is going to be a memory state, which means the changes will not affect. So in our previous class, we have clearly explained what is meant by a memory state, which means these values, the values at the output will remain the same, they will not change. Whenever the input is 1-1, the values on the queue, at the queue, will remain the same and it will not create any impact on the input. So that is the reason why the clock is generated. So whenever the clock is 1, then only the changes will happen. So how these changes will happen, we will try to understand in a clear way. So our request is to focus on this video very, very with high concentration, because so this explanation, if you are able to understand this explanation, the upcoming flip-flop that we are going to see, they are very much easy to understand. So the next coming flip-flops, or the basis for the next coming flip-flops, is totally based upon this video. So try to focus on this. We will try to make this concept as simple as possible, and we will try to make you understand in a very slow way. Okay, so now what is the output? So we will try to create a characteristic table for this flip-flop. So in this characteristics table, what is the definition of a sequential circuit? As we have said that in sequential circuit, the present output, okay? So try to be very clear about this. So this makes a lot of difference. So the present output, which means it is Qn plus 1. So the present output, for example, if you assume this as Qn, so this Qn is the previous input, right? Previous output, right? So that previous output will get changed to Qn plus 1. So both Qn and Qn plus 1 represent the same output, but the perception towards the input and output is varying. So what does that mean is, so as we have said that in a sequential circuit, the present output depends upon the present input and the previous output. The present output that we are going to get, so the new output that we are going to get, which is Qn plus 1, Qn plus 1 is dependent upon present inputs. So what are the present inputs here? The present inputs are S and R, and also it is dependent upon previous input. So what is the previous input? If you take the previous input as Qn, the present input is going to be Qn plus 1. So the present output, the output that we are going to get right now, is dependent upon the present input S and R, and also the previous output. What is the previous output? It is Qn. Okay. So now the inputs are going to be, the inputs to generate Qn plus 1 are S, R, Qn. So in order to get the Qn plus 1, the inputs that we are needed are S, R, Qn. So this point is very much important to understand, because based upon this, we are going to generate the characteristics table. So what is the characteristic table? That the inputs that we are going to have in the characteristic table are S, R, Qn, and the output is going to be Qn plus 1. Okay, now we will try to see each and every aspect of these inputs, which is 000, 001, 010, 011, 100, 110, 110, and 111. Okay, so now these are the inputs. Let's differentiate them based upon the inputs. Okay, so whenever the values of S and R are 0 0, whenever the inputs are S and R are 0 0, and the Qn is 0. Qn is 0 means this one is 0. So the new Qn plus 1 that will get generated at the output, what it is going to be, that we are going to understand step by step. Every aspect we will try to understand with every aspect. So for example, initially when the value of S and R are 0, 0 and the clock is 1, so whenever the clock is 1, then only the circuit will work. Whenever the clock is 0, the circuit will not change. The concept has already been discussed. Okay, so now with this 0, 1 means it is going to produce an output of 1, and 1, 0 means it is going to produce an output of 1 because it is a NAND gate. So we have seen the NAND gate function. So we'll take it here for better understanding. Okay, so now the input is 0, 1, 0, 1, which is provided to this NAND gate, which is going to be 1. 0, 1 means 1 and 1, 0 means 1. So now whenever 1, 1 is there, whenever 1, 1 is there, what happens? So we have seen in our previous video, whenever the NAND SR latch with NAND gates is provided with 1, 1, it is going to be a memory state or latch state, which means that the previous values will remain the same. So what is the previous value that we have here? It is 0. So for example, if it is provided with 0, 1, 0, 1 means it is going to be 1. And this one is provided here and it is going to be 0. So there is no change in the Qn. The Qn remains the same. This point is very important to understand. So the Qn plus 1. So the new output that we got at Qn is, which is Qn plus 1, is 1. Okay. Now the output, the input of S and R are same. And but the Qn value is 1. So the previous value of Qn is 1. So then what happens? So this is going to be 1, 1. This is going to be 1, 1. Let's see. This one, 1 will be provided here. 1, 1 is going to produce an output of 0. And this is 0, 1. And this one is going to be 1. Again 1, 1, 0, 0, 1. It is going to be 1. So that 1 value will remain the same. So whenever the input of SR is 0 and the clock is provided and the value at the Qn is 1, the value in the Qn will remain the same. So it is the Qn plus 1 is going to be 1. So the next step is, the next input is S is equal to 0, R is equal to 1 and Qn is equal to 0. S is equal to 0, R is equal to 1. R is equal to 1 and Qn is equal to 0. Now these values will change. Let's see. It is 0, 1. 0, 1 means it is going to produce an output of 1. 1, 1, it is going to produce an output of 0. If the value of clock is 0, always it is going to be 1, 1. Whenever these values are 1, 1, in our previous video, we have seen that this circuit, this part of the circuit will remain in the memory state, which means that the previous values will remain the same. So I am stressing this point again and again because this point is very much important to understand. Okay, right now. So we got 1, 0 here and the previous input is Qn is 0. Qn is 0. So it is going to be 0, 0, which is going to produce an output of 1. 1, 1, it is going to produce an output of 0. So this is going to be a 0. Okay. Now again the values of S and R are 1, 1 and the next input is 1. So whenever the Qn is having an output of 1, what happens? So when it is 0, 1 and 1, so it is going to produce 1, 0 and now the input is going to be 0, 1, 0, 1, see here, 0, 1, it is going to produce an output of 1 and this is going to be 1, 1 and it will be producing 0. Okay. So this is going to be 0. Okay. So the next input is 1, 0. 1, 0. Okay. So now let's check 1, 0 and the value of Qn is 0. Value of Qn is 0, which means the previous input is 0. Now what happens is, So 1 1 it is going to produce an output of 0, and 1 0 it is going to produce an output of 1. Now 1 0 1 will get produced, 1 0 1 will get produced, again 1 1 here. In the previous it is 0 1, now it has been made to 1 1. So 1 1, so again it will produce an output of 0. See here. So these are the steps that are needed to settle down the circuit. So in order to make the circuit settle down, so these many number of times these inputs are to be iterated, later the circuit will get settled down. So this discussion has already been made in our previous video. See here. So this is 1. Whenever the value of S is 1 and R is 0, so the value of output is going to be 1, and Qn is 0, it is going to produce an output of 1. And similarly 0 1, okay, this one is 0 1, and here if the value of this is 1, so how it is going to be? So now 1 1 it is going to produce a 0, 0 0 it is going to produce an output of 1. Again 1 1 0 0 0 it is going to produce an output of 1. So those values are depending upon this NAND gate. Okay. So now the Qn is going to be 1, and Q bar is always going to be the complement. So whenever the Qn is 1, it has to produce a 0. Whenever the Qn is 0, it has to produce it is producing an output of 1. So observe this also. Okay. Now the input is 1 1. So whenever the input is 1 1, so now here it is going to be the clock is 1 and the Qn is equal to 0. In this case what happens? Let's check. So it is going to produce an output of 1 1. So 1 1 means, sorry, it is 0 0. Now 0 0 it is going to produce an output of 0, and this is 0 0 and it is going to produce an output of 0 0, which is not desirable. So we have discussed about these concepts. They are invalid outputs. So in our previous SR latch, we have said that the inputs at 0, if the inputs are 1, 1, they are invalid states. Those inputs are the don't care inputs. Okay. So these values are don't care. So whatever the value of, if you are having a value of 1 here. So now check. 0, 1, it is going to produce an output of 1. And 0 1 again it is going to produce an output of 1. See here. So either it is going to produce a 1 or 0 at both Q and Q bar, because we said that it has to produce whenever this value is Q, it has to be complemented. Q is 1, it has to be complemented. Q bar has to, but we are getting same values of Q and Q, Q bar at the whenever we are producing the inputs of S and R as 0, and both these are invalid states. Invalid. So we are not caring about this outputs, and these inputs are not valid in the SR gate. So this discussion has already been in our SR latch. And see here, whenever the value of S is 1, we are going to set the outputs. Whenever the values of R is equal to 1, we are going to reset. So the discussion has already been made. Whenever the values of SR are 0, 0, the values will remain the same. So this is what we call it as memory or latch state. You can call it any way. We can call it either it as a memory state or latch state. So this is what we call it as an SR gate with clocked input, which means that this is what we call it as a SR flip-flop. When we call it as a flip-flop is whenever the transition, whenever the inputs are allowed into the circuit, whenever the transition is done at this point. So edge triggered flip-flops, if the clock is edge triggered clock, then only it is called as a flip-flop. Edge triggered means whenever this transition is happening, then only the inputs will be allowed. It is a positive edge and this is a negative edge triggered. So whenever the trigger, so whenever the clock is positive edge, so positive edge is means whenever the transition is done from 0 to 1. So this is the time span where the inputs are allowed into the circuit. So after that the inputs will not be allowed even the clock is 1. Okay, so this is what we call it as edge triggered clock. So if the clock that is provided to the clocked SR latch is edge triggered clock, then only it is called as a flip flop. So this point is very important to understand. So now we will try to generate the Boolean function for this Qn plus 1, which means with not only this circuit, we can create another circuit also. So using another circuits, we can create the same SR latch effect. So now we will try to minimize that function. So how to minimize that function? It is by using see here, it is by using our minimization technique by KMAP SR QN 00011110 and 01. So wherever the values are 1 here, 1 and 100 here, 1 and next is 1011, and these two are don't cares. Okay, so now the minimization is this one and the other one is this one. So this one is going to be QN, okay, QN, and this minimization is SR bar. So this is the characteristic function for SR gate. So not only this circuit, we can use the another circuit like this one, so which is going to be SR bar, and the other input is QN plus 1. So this is the feedback, right? So the previous one will be provided as the input to this circuit. This is the another circuit for SR flip-flop. So using that also, we can store the values onto the circuit. Okay, so this is about SR clocked SR latch. In the next class, we will try to understand excitation table for SR flip-flop. So why we need to understand excitation table and how an excitation table for the SR flip-flop can be generated, that we will try to understand in our next video. So this video and the next video are very important for the remaining part of the course, where we are going to deal with different types of flip-flops. Hope you got the clarity on this concept. Thanks for watching. If you are not able to understand this video in a single watch, please watch this video as many times as possible until you get the clarity. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon for the latest updates. And if you have any doubts regarding this concept, please post your doubts in the comment section below. Thanks for watching.